This gene, which is called ARCAN1, what we did in these mouse studies was to remove it from mice, and then we put them on a high-fat diet. And what we found was mice on a high-fat diet that lack this gene gain no weight. But if we extrapolate it to humans, these drugs that we're trying to develop that target this pathway would result in burning more calories and storing less fat without the need to change diet or improve diet or increase our exercise, which I think are major issues for a lot of people in trying to lose weight. And the ideal would be to be able to take some sort of pill that didn't require to watch your diet, that didn't require to exercise. Now that might seem like a pipe dream, but the findings that we have out of this mouse study at least indicate a novel pathway that we might be able to target that could eventuate into the development of such a pill. Removing ARCAN1 had two major effects. So in fat cells, it reduced the storage of fat in dangerous areas around the belly, for example. And then in muscle, it actually caused muscle to burn more calories at rest. We looked at a variety of different diets over a variety of different time spans from 8 weeks to say 6 months. And we saw improvements in health of mice on all of these different types of diets in the absence of this gene. We're really hopeful that these drugs or prototypes of these drugs could eventually be used to help treat obesity in humans. Anti-obesity treatments in terms of the utilisation of drugs have typically not been successful. And so this was the impetus for a lot of this work in the first place, trying to develop, identify new pathways that we could target with drugs, and that's certainly where we stand at the moment. Obesity is associated with a lot of health disorders, most especially type 2 diabetes, but also cancer, for example, and is a growing health burden in Australia and across the world. So we really want to try and pursue this and try to develop some novel therapeutics to try and treat obesity. This is exciting what we found so far. We are trying to pursue it further. We have funding from the federal government, which is helping us to do that at the moment. But you know, this is the type of stuff that gets us excited in this job, trying to impact on human health in a real way.